after your workout, like a kind of an individual session with like the coaches?
That was the first time actually shooting. We talked about that in some other places, but that was the first time I actually like worked out again.
It was DA and Ryan. Why did they? Did you request that or did they?
No, they did. They just wanted to see me shoot a little bit more.
Have you been in Ohio State? Forgive me if you have, and I should know this, but have you been the initiator in a pick and roll? Because at first they had you pick and roll and then you shoot. Later they had you in a pick and pop. Have you been an initiator?
Yeah, I was doing a little bit of both in college.
Which one do you think you're more comfortable with?
Definitely the coming off, not coming off, the setting the screen.
The setting the screen,
just slipping out of it.
What makes you think, or what makes you such a good rebounder and blocker for your size? The numbers would suggest like 6'9", 6'10", or something like that.
I mean, it's definitely my length. I'm extremely long wingspan, so it enables me to get balls I normally wouldn't get, or most guys wouldn't get.
With your versatility and, you know, obviously being like the small warrior, how do you feel like that's going to help you on both ends of the floor?
I find that's perfect for my game. Like you said, the small ball area, guys that are versatile and can switch and guard multiple positions, that's perfect for my game.
Is there someone in the NBA that you feel like, you know, your game is similar to, or that you model your game after?
Not just one guy, because I know a lot of guys do a bunch of different things. Everyone switches and does so much. I kind of try and take a little bit from everybody.
During these pre-draft workouts, what are you trying to show teams that they might not know from your college game?
My shooting ability, I can't shoot the ball better than the percentage I shot in college, and then just keep showing my length and versatility.
You've been projected as high as 15 and all the way to 34. Why do you think that? And do you pay attention to mock drafts?
I don't know exactly why. I don't pay attention either. I was kind of just focused on logic control, just these workouts, and just doing as best I can.
What do you think of this process that you're kind of going through, going from team to team, having to work out, having to sort of, you know, job interviews? How do you like the process?
I like it so far. You know, traveling around, seeing, you know, trying my different game in different places, and meeting a bunch of different people. It's been a good process.
Anything that stands out from any of the prior stops or this one that you found kind of interesting about, you know, as you're going into your next step?
Yeah, they're all pretty much the same. We do the same type of drill, shooting drill, split up guards and bigs, and then one-on-one, three-on-three. They're all pretty much the same. It's just a different personality.
With your crazy wingspan ability to rebound, can you show defensive ability in these workouts when you're going one-on-one or three-on-three?
Yeah, definitely. It's open floor. It's no help side pretty much. You can see if you can guard, you know, person one-on-one.
Who are you going up against today?
Mostly the guards. It's just a little bit of mostly the smaller guys that are out there.
But you have to follow. I saw some of them. They look quick. You have to follow them?
Yeah, chasing around screens and off-ball screens. They're pretty quick. Right? I do well.
Saw you operate out the post a little bit in college. You feel like that gives you a leg up?
Definitely, because if a smaller guy switches, I'm comfortable, you know, going to the post like I did, especially a lot in my last college season.